To find out, we've set up our own Brain Games red carpet here in Jackson Square. And we're inviting people to have their photo taken. Don't smile, all right? Just kind of be neutral. All
right.
You got it?
Got it.
While he processes that image, we're going to play a little game
all
over
right.
here. In addition to having their photos taken, we're also asking people to look at the photos of other people that we photographed today. All right, now as you can see in front of you, there's three different tablets, three pictures, three ladies. Three tablets, three gentlemen. Take a look at all three faces, study them closely. While our volunteers are busy looking at photos, let's play a game. See this image? It's upside down, and only parts of it are visible. But can you tell what it is? Most of you likely figured out it's a pineapple. But how about this one? Any ideas? Even though you probably assumed it was upside down, most people still have trouble figuring out this image is a face. This is because our brains process faces differently from objects. While our brains see objects as a whole, we see each part of a face individually. The eyes, nose, hair, chin, and so on. Because tiny differences in each part of a face clue us into the identity of a person. And our brain's abilities of facial perception are uniquely powerful.
Who beckons the most? Decide which one you think is the most attractive. Tell me who you're most drawn to.
I'm gonna go with number three.
Number three, huh?
Yes.
For sure.
Yes.
I think him.
Yeah?
He looks humane and kind.
Kind of like you know him.
Maybe, yeah.
Which one speaks to you? Which one calls to you? This one over here?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's really interesting. You know why? Well, people are more drawn to familiar images than unfamiliar ones. This is what neuroscientists tell us. Because thousands of years ago, that it was a way to quickly identify those that were part of our tribe and a way to tell enemies from friends.
Okay.
And in this case, you might be seeing something in him that reminds you of you. So, can you sense anything in there that you recognize?
What do you think? Want to take a guess as to why she chose him and he chose her?
All right, so she's actually part you. 22% of him is actually you.
What?
22% of her face is your face.
We have
these Photoshop specialist friends up there known as Fojo, who've inserted 22% of your features into this guy's face to create a composite that you would be attracted to without knowing why. And so in a way, you're drawn to her because you see yourself.
Oh, that's awesome.
That is so weird.
Over 75% of our volunteers chose pictures that contained part of their own face morph into a stranger's. But is it really that big a deal to take pride in our own profile? Well, when your brain engages in prideful behavior, your medial prefrontal cortex is notably quiet. That's your brain region associated with introspection. And the result is self-deception, a you that's a little too willing to celebrate your you-ness.
How's that for pride?
Everywhere.